As a software developer, what do you know about search engine optimization, otherwise known as SEO? So SEO is super important to any web app or web site that you do as a developer, because that's what's going to affect the visibility your website or app has on Google search engines, which is how 99% of your unknown visitors are going to find your site. Search engine optimization is the process of optimizing your website's presence to the search engine crawlers like Google or Bing or Yahoo search or any one of those older ones. But the main one that you want to focus on is Google. So as a developer, you want to keep SEO in mind as you're developing your website or web app, because that's your main organic, that's the main way of getting organic traffic to a website from these search engines. So I have a couple tips for developers and managing SEO and improving the SEO of a website or web app. So the first tip is mobile first. Google uses mobile first indexing. So you want to make sure your website is designed toward mobile devices first. So since Google's using this mobile first indexing, they're gonna use a crawler bot to search and index your page first, as that pretends to be like a mobile web browser. So you want to make sure on mobile your website works well. What's above the fold, which means what's in the screen when it first loads, you want to make sure that's pretty clear to Google, and it's pretty, and all your important information is there. You also want to make sure you have the meta viewport tag, if it's for a website or web app, that sets the viewport correctly for mobile friendly websites. You want to definitely develop mobile first, keeping the SEO in mind that Google will use their crawlers to make their search engine listings. They will crawl mobile first. So that's very important to developers when creating their websites and web apps. Okay, the next tip is having static and super clean URLs. So that, it means a variety of things. First of all, you want the web URLs to be secure, meaning HTTPS and not just HTTP. So Google prefers websites that are secure. They have more trust in it, and if they have more trust, they're gonna rank your website higher than someone that doesn't have their SSL certificate and is not serving the website over HTTPS versus HTTP. And also, you want to make sure that all your URLs are human readable and not machine readable. So instead of having, you know, www.website.com/blog/2253 for the first blog post, you might want that to be slash whatever the name of the blog post is with dashes between it, so that Google can index the actual name of that blog page and not just some crazy numbers that don't make any sense. Google actually use those as keywords when people search if you have keywords in your actual URL. You also want to make sure different variations of your URL all redirect to the same. So, you know, as you know, index.html is usually the root of a folder. You rather that redirect to whatever the folder name is if someone typed that in, so that Google just sees one URL and not these different types of URLs that have the same thing, which confuses it. And when Google gets confused, it usually ranks you lower. So you don't want it to be confused at all. Also, if a page has been removed from your website, you want to do a 301 redirect to let Google know that it isn't just, you know, you want to give Google as much information as possible when trying to figure out where a web page has been removed to or moved to. So my next tip is internal linking. So anything that deserves an extra page, you want to go ahead and make a separate page for it and link to it. And when you link to it, you want to use real HTML, you know, A tag links, and not using JavaScript on click events to do your linking. This is because Google search crawlers, when it crawls your website, it's going through links. It's not processing JavaScript. It's not going to do all this human stuff to try to go find your links. It's going to look for tags on the page, and that's what it's going to follow to link. And when it links that, it indexes that and puts that in the search results. But when you don't do it that way, when you use HTML, it doesn't, the crawler can get stuck and not get to the page that it needs to get to. Also, you want to make sure there's a thing called Google Search Console. You want to make sure your website is signed up for that, and you want to submit what is called a sitemap. Just Google that, how to make one. You want to submit that to Google to let it know what pages you have right now, and it can go ahead and index those pages. You can proactively let it know what to index. It's not a promise that they'll index it and put you up really high, but it's at least a you're at least giving them a kind of a kick in the butt to know that your website is there and these are the pages that it has. The next thing is page structuring and tagging. So you want to make sure your content on your page is visible and not hidden when you can help it. You know, I know there's sites that are really dynamic and show different things. You want to try to avoid that as much as possible and put all the information on the page so that Google's crawlers can read that information and index it. You want as much content on the page as possible so that when people search on the internet, they can find these different keywords on your page. So you don't want a lot of hidden text. Google's crawlers don't like hidden text, and they can't hit buttons to open your text or collapsible fields and stuff like that. They can't always do those things. So you want to make sure that stuff is at least visible on the page so that the crawlers can pick it up. Also, you want to separate your page in the right way so that using headers and using the HTML header tags, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6, so that Google knows what sections things are in and what's the titles for each section based on those H1 through H6 tags. And they will actually use that to index your page. If you ever seen like a Google listing or search engine result that has like titles and, you know, it has the result and it has different subsections under it, well, it can use those different tags if you structure your page correctly when you're coding it to help with the SEO and put things in divisions. And also when people search, it can help boost you as an authority if it sees that great organization and lots of content in each of these subsections about a different result or a different page that you have or different pages that you have. You also want to make sure any images you have on the page have alt text tags on them, because Google's bots can't see what's in an image. So the alt text that you add on an HTML image tag is what Google will see and associate with it. And also that will tie these images to Google image search results. So your image on your page, if you put the right tag on it, if it's a picture of a cat and you put cat in the image tag, you want to be more descriptive than that, but because that's pretty competitive for cat. But if you say that it is a coding cat or something like that, every time somebody searches coding cat, they may not even find your website. They may find an image on your website, click on it, takes them to your website, and there may be some context and valuable information or a valuable experience for you and for the customer or visitor that just from having that image tagged correctly. You also want to use what they're called social schema tags and meta tags in your header, that if it's a blog post or an article or something that could be shared on social, Twitter has tags that they recommend you use, Facebook has tags. If you Google it, you can find a jumbo set of tags that you should set on a page so that anytime your page or content is shared on social media, that the tags will match up correctly and the information will display correctly on these external sites. Where Google and search engines and SEO comes into this is that there are specific tags that Google also looks for to help rank and style your result. So you want to make sure you're doing everything you can to make Google happy as far as how, you know, giving it extra information to rank your result and put you one leg up above any competitors that are close to your page, around your page content relevance. All right, the next thing, backlinks. So backlinks are super important to build trust with Google and help them rank your website higher. Backlinks are links from other websites to the website that we're talking about in this context. So it's important to know as a developer, if you have other websites that are related, you want to always make sure you're linking them together, especially if you have one that's already proven to be reputable with Google. You want to make sure you send some backlinks because Google uses trust from already trusted sites to give extra trust to new sites. So the more backlinks you can get, if you can get backlinks from other people you know, do it. If you can get backlinks from news sites or any backlinks you can get, you want to build those backlinks up. Also, if you're a developer, One trick is when you have clients, when you do their websites and you put your little made by so-and-so at the bottom, make sure that links back to your website. If they build their website up to be highly reputable on Google, having that backlink from their website will help you be reputable too, help your website be reputable and get more, help your SEO for your own personal website. So that's kind of like a developer hack there that I use for a lot of my clients' websites. All right, the next thing is page speed and performance. So this is how fast does your web page load. Google uses this as a page ranking factor, how fast it loads. And if your web page is loading really slow and shows a history of loading slow, Google will rank you lower. So some things you want to do as a developer to curb this is use a CDN that can deliver media files fast, like your images, code, CSS, JavaScript, all your files. Also, you want to minimize your files, compress your image files to the smallest but good quality as possible. You want to minimize your JavaScript files to be delivered to the page in the smallest size as possible, so they're downloaded really fast. And there's a number of other things you can do, but that's a good start as a developer to help increase your page speed. So next, I wanted to also talk about SPAs, which are single page applications. SPAs historically cause a problem for Google for search engine optimization because the page loads, it's a single page, which refreshes its contents, which is bad for SEO because a SPA usually starts out with a really light HTML page that has barely anything on it, and then it dynamically loads its content into it. But a search engine crawler will come see that blank kind of small page and just kind of give up, or it may get some of the content, it may not get all of it, or it may get the start of it, but it doesn't get all the dynamic pieces. So SPAs typically cause a problem for it, but there's some ways as a developer you can get around some of that. These SPAs are typically used, built using frameworks like React and Vue.js. With React and Vue.js, I think there are some new frameworks built on top of them, I think called Nuxt. I might be butchering that, but I think it's Nuxt and Next for React and Nuxt for Vue that will do server-side rendering of your app. So they will take your different pages. They're SEO-friendly frameworks for these typically SPA frameworks like React and Vue. They're kind of an abstraction on top that will separate your app into actual pages and deliver these actual pages to the front end so that the search engine can pick them up a lot better than they can with a typical SPA. So check those out if you get a chance, but that will definitely help you with the SEO in a single page application, giving you the best of both worlds. You're able to do a single page application and use these nice frameworks. You're also that able to have separate pages that get indexed properly by Google. So lastly, I wanted to share a few tools, and some of them I talked about earlier, but a few tools to help you as a developer up your game with SEO. The first tool is Google Search Console. This is probably the most important tool. This is a tool that Google provides themselves to say, hey, send me your site map of your website with all the pages that it has, and let us start there. We get that information first before we go out and crawl your website, and it gives kind of a head start, gives Google a head start, and this lets them know that you're there, especially when you have a new website. Google Search Console also shows you so much information about your website once you set it up, where you're getting traffic from organically, what keywords are being used to find your website, what pages that people are mostly clicking on and going to from Google, and a lot of other helpful information and reports, which can help you get better at SEO because you see what's working, you see what's not. The next is Neil Patel's SEO Analyzer. This tool is by a great SEO expert called Neil Patel. He has this tool that you can put your URL in or page in, and it will just go through a bunch of analysis of your website and give you a bunch of grades and tips and errors for things that you did wrong with your SEO on that page. And it's a beautiful tool to use to help you kind of learn about SEO and also fix problems with SEO in your website. And as a developer, it tells you like exactly technically what you need to do in each case. to improve the SEO on the page. And you can keep testing it again after you fix stuff and see that it gets better. And it's a great cheat sheet to be able to improve the SEO and make sure you don't forget things. The next thing is the Facebook social debugger. This is a tool that Facebook gives so you can put your link in and it'll give you a preview of how it will look on Facebook. And this is a good indicator of how your meta tag data on your page, the stuff I talked about earlier, is being viewed by these different social media websites. Because you want to make sure that information is keyword rich, it makes sense for the post. If somebody shared this, would people want to click on it? If Google, if a bot saw this, would it be able to understand it and take the keywords and serve it to people who are searching for it? But you want to make sure that most importantly about everything, you know, I know it's a lot of bot-driven work as far as the crawlers, but Google prefers you for you to serve things for humans and not for bots. So even though they're using bots to using crawlers or bots to scrape the internet and create these list pages and search pages and the search engine that they have, you know, they prefer you to make human readable content and metadata. So you want to try to lean that way. And I think this Facebook debugger kind of helps you do that in a certain way. The next thing is Next.js and Nuxt.js for React.js and Vue.js respectively. These are frameworks built on top of those frameworks that help you build SEO friendly spot applications and not just spot applications that struggle with SEO. These will allow you to do server render pages that actually, you know, you can separate your actual pages in your application, and each page will be rendered from the server to the front end, where if a crawler sees it, it actually has a page to look at and not just a placeholder page that's being dynamically updated like in a traditional spa. So that defeats the problem that of SEO that spas usually had in the past. So those are great tools to use. The last is a link, and all these links are down in the description. But last is a link to what is it called? MOS, Moz, meta tags for structured content. These are all the meta tags for Twitter, the ones that Google likes, the ones that Instagram or Facebook likes to see. And it's just a big jumbo section of stuff, of a template that you can just add to all your pages and make sure that the information is properly filled out so that all the metadata for your page is correctly seen by search engines as well as social media sites. And that's all. I hope you enjoyed this these tips, and I hope they help you in your developer journey and as far as getting more eyes on the stuff that you're working on, either for yourself or for clients. SEO is an important part of anything we build, especially on the web. If you're marketing it or if you're, you know, productizing it, people need to be able to find it. They need to be able to search for it and find it organically. So even as a developer, you know, these things are important. Somebody else may make some of the decisions about it, but there are technical things you need to do to make sure the SEO is properly implemented. And so I hope this helps. Let me know if you have any tips of your own for SEO. I don't know everything, and I know I miss things. It's hard to cover everything. So yeah, just have a conversation. Let me know if there's things that you learned over your work with SEO that can improve that. And I hope this was valuable, and see you in the next video.